Good morning, everybody, ladies and gentlemen. For best introducing and translate, I present you Kim Leduc, from Dunham, Quebec, and she translates English to French because my French accent is so strong. I'm very afraid you don't understand me. Okay, so I'm take a few minutes to present. It's okay for the sound? Okay. I present Pipeline Montreal project to beginning in 2008 at Dunham. I present you this project, and today I present you the resistance and organization for the citizens of Dunham. And actually, we work to stop this project. And this project may be beginning in 2010 for the translate and for l'inversion du flux.
The flow inversion. The project was slated to start in 2010. It involves changing the substance that goes through 60-year-old pipes and also a flow inversion.
And actually, it stopped. We are in 2011. And the company not beginning anything for this project. So I'm show you the creating resistance of the citizen of Dunham.
Je vais exposer en fait notre objectif de citoyen, c'est avant tout de prévenir la population des risques. Concernant la construction d'une station de pompage pétrolière en pleine campagne dans notre village.
One of the first priorities was to educate the population of Dunham and letting them know what was going on and the dangers involved.
Exposer aussi à la population du Québec les risques et les dangers inhérents au sable bitumineux en Alberta et à travers le Canada.
Also, we needed to make the public of Quebec at large aware of the issue, the local issue, and also the more global issue of the tar sands.
Et parallèlement, le pipeline qui devrait être utilisé pour l'inversion a 60 ans. C'est le plus vieux pipeline utilisé au Canada actuellement et le plus dangereux.
The pipeline that they're planning to use for this, to add a pumping station to and reverse the flow of, is 60 years old, and it is one of, if not the oldest pipeline in Canada.
Le projet de pipeline Montréal est lié à Trailbreaker, qui part de l'Alberta et qui doit rejoindre le port de Portland dans le Maine.
The name of the project is really an Enbridge project. It's called Trailbreaker, and
qui passe par Montréal jusqu'à Portland.
Okay, alors it goes from Portland, Maine to Montreal.
Et vous pouvez voir la ligne 7 et 9 qui passe également en Ontario par Sarnia.
So you can also see lines 7 and 9 that pass by Sarnia and in Ontario.
Si vous regardez Montréal, Portland, c'est la trajectoire de notre pipeline qui a 60 ans.
Okay, from Montreal to Portland, that's the 60-year-old pipeline that's involved in the Trailbreaker project and which we are struggling against. But the whole project is called Enbridge and it starts at Sarnia and goes to Portland.
Plus précisément, la ligne du pipeline Montréal-Portland a été créée en 1941.
Originally, the pipeline was created in 19. Well, that line, which was a 12-inch pipeline, was created in 1941.
Actuellement, il y a deux stations de pompage qui existent au Québec, une à Saint-Césaire, l'autre à Highwater sur la frontière.
Okay, so right now there are two pumping stations which exist on the Quebec side of that pipeline. One is in Saint-Césaire and the other one is in Highwater.
Actuellement, le pipeline est utilisé dans le sens Portland-Montréal.
Okay, right now it flows in the sense of Portland to Montreal.
Le projet d'inversion pour le sable bitumineux, c'est Montréal-Portland.
Okay, so for the Trail Creeper project, they're going to reverse the flow so that it goes from Montreal to Portland, Maine.
Le projet Pipeline Montréal pour la station de pompage est lié à la montagne de Sutton qui barre la route dans le sens Montréal-Portland.
Okay. Well, right now, the pipeline, when it was going from Portland to Montreal, it was being the oil was being pumped over Mount Sutton at the high water pumping station. Now, when they reverse the flow, they're going to have to put a pumping station on the other side of the mountain, which happens to be Dunham, where we live.
Voici la place prévue pour le projet en pleine campagne, proche des montagnes de Sutton, à Dunham.
Well, this is the place that they want to. This is the visual of the place where they want to put the pumping station. It's in. Right in an agricultural land. It's known for its beauty, and we actively encourage tourism and small agriculture, organic agriculture, actually.
Actuellement, le pipeline traverse la campagne sous ces aspects. Traversant une ligne droite entre Montréal et Portland, traversant des champs, des forêts. Okay. Okay. I'm going first. Okay. Just for the pipeline train, sometime we find this one is hors terre, il est hors terre, ce qui nous a permis de bloquer le processus de Montréal Pipeline, car les pipelines doivent être underground, doivent être sous terre.
Well, this is part of the investigation of our group, was to look at the pipeline, that the existing pipeline on the mountain. This is what we found. It's illegal. It is supposed to be underground. And this is part of the information that has gotten the Energy Board interested, so that they came to visit us last week to check out the installations.
En tant que citoyen, on a accès sur les risques concernant les installations en place. Vous avez les deux stations Saint-Césaire ici. Vous avez la station de Saint-Césaire. Nous avons trouvé des fuites de pétrole de 45 000 litres en 1999.
45 000 litres. Okay, there was already been an accident in 1950 at the Saint-Césaire pumping station, where it was 45,000 liters of oil that was spilled.
La station de Highwater a eu aussi plusieurs fuites qui n'étaient pas déclarées par la compagnie dans les années 1980.
So the other pumping station, which is on the other side of Mount Sutton, also had some spills which were never declared in the 1980s.
Lors des présentations de la compagnie à tous les villages le long du pipeline, le comité environnement de Nam était présent pour indiquer les fuites, problèmes et accidents de la compagnie.
Okay, everywhere the company goes to talk to locals and members of our committee follow to inform people about the facts on the spills, the dangers, and the history of the company.
Nous avons fait aussi une campagne de présentation sur les problématiques du sable bitumineux en Alberta et les risques d'accidents avec Enbridge et tous les pipelines qui sont au Canada qui ont des problèmes d'accidents.
Okay, so not only do we focus on the local problems, but we also expose and talk about the problems in Canada concerning pipelines in general and the affected communities.
Sans oublier BP aux États-Unis.
Yeah, and we also mentioned BP in the United States, and on his blog he mentions just about every spill that's happening that he can get in touch with in the world, in Europe.
Depuis 2008, le CED de Nam, avec un groupe de citoyens, aussi a bloqué le processus au niveau des institutions publiques, gouvernementales, au niveau provincial Québec, au niveau fédéral.
Okay, so at every stage of the acceptance process, where the company needs the approval of government institutions, for example, the municipality or the provincial environment
provincial
environment. What word is it? Ministry. Exactly.
Thank you.
And we intervene at every level.
Et pour finir, le processus actuel aujourd'hui est que l'Office national de l'énergie a envoyé des experts sur les deux stations de pompage et a demandé à la compagnie Pipeline Montréal de vérifier l'état du pipeline au complet.
Okay, so it's a bit, I jumped the gun before. He's saying that where we're at right now is that the Energy Board has come down this week, and it's to check out two of the pumping stations to see the state of the pipes and also to get the company to really make sure that the pipes are in good condition.
Également au niveau du ministère de l'Environnement du Québec, le ministre vient la semaine prochaine lui-même nous rencontrer pour pouvoir discuter du projet Pipeline Montréal à Donham, car étant donné les accidents qu'il y a eu depuis 2008, maintenant les autorités prennent très au sérieux les risques d'accidents.
Okay, so the Minister of Environment is coming down next week to meet members of the municipality and our group, I believe. Yeah. To discuss, because there's been so much information going on in our area, and it's not just us. I mean, there are many groups that are working on the issue, and so they're coming down to meet us and to discuss.
And pour finir, la meilleure manière de résister, c'est encore de pouvoir chercher l'information sur la compagnie, sur son histoire.
The best way to resist is to do the research. What we have found so far is to research the company, get the information, get the past, the history.
Ne pas les confronter directement, mais passer par les médias ou les conseillers, les institutions.
So far, we haven't gone head-on with them. We pass through feeding lots of information through the media and public officials.
Et je vous engage à chercher dans le passé de chaque compagnie, parce qu'il y a toujours quelque chose de négatif contre eux.
He really encourages everybody to look in the past and the history, and he did a lot of work on through public information. What's it called? Public access to information to get the history of the company, because every company has got dirty little stories.
And thank you very much.
Okay.